If you are a beginner in shoemaking, just getting started, this tutorial is for you. In this tutorial, I will show you three reasons why this is where you need to start.
Learn how to make shoes with my step-by-step video courses.
So you are a beginner in shoemaking and want to learn shoemaking and make your shoes. Where to start? How to start? Does it matter from which shoe model is better to start learning shoemaking? Yes, it matters. And thousands of my students proved it with their work. This tutorial is first tutorial from series of videos that I will publish in upcoming weeks, where I will show you how and where to start making your shoes to achieve best results, to progress faster, and most important, to have beautiful and comfortable shoes. In this tutorial, I will show you three important reasons why flat body shoes is the first shoe model that you should start from. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel and click the bell button to be notified when my new video will come out. So let's start. First thing is foundation. Flat body shoes has basic foundation. All other footwear types are based on the construction that has flat body shoes, like derby shoes, Oxford shoes, moccasins, T-strap pumps, loafers, sneakers, and even boots are constructed on this basic foundation, plus some specific extra lines and points that belongs to each other footwear types. But it's much easier to start from these flat body shoes because it has this principle foundation. So what is the foundation? It consists from four anatomical lines: back central line, front central line, joint line, and side line. You should find all this line correctly on every shoe last size, so the shoes will not bother you here on the bone where we have bones on our feet. If you will find this line too higher, it will bother your bone. If it will be too lower, it will slide down from your feet. If you will find the throat line of that body shoes too low, it will squeeze your feet. Too high, it will squeeze your feet. If too low, it will slide down from your shoes and it will not be pretty shoes. Okay? So this is why it's so important to know all these anatomical lines, because you want to have not only beautiful shoes for Instagram, you want to have beautiful shoes and comfortable shoes for yourself. Now, I will show you how easy it will be to construct almost each footwear type when you will know how to create flat body shoes. For example, I will show you how to create moccasins, how to design moccasins. But let's start from flat body shoes, so you will see what is the difference and why flat body shoes has basic foundation and why you should start your shoemaking learning from this footwear type. And it doesn't matter if you're a man or woman, I recommend for all my students to start from flat body shoes. So now I'll design flat body shoes, simple classic flat body shoes, and then I will design moccasins. So you will compare these two designs and will understand that moccasins that looks differently than flat body shoes will have same foundation. Okay, so this is the design of flat body shoes. It's simple classic design. I can make here different shape. It depends on the design of your flat body shoes. Now, based on same lines, central line, joint line, and side line, and back central line, I will design moccasins. It also can be the loafers. We work a lot with measurement tape. So if I will finish like this, it will be moccasins. If I will add here this extra detail, it will be already loafers. Okay, so you see, I didn't change here a lot the construction. I used here another points that I need to know to create moccasins or loafers, but the foundation is the same: the central line, the side line, the joint line, and the central back line. Okay, that's why I always recommend to reach best results, to learn shoemaking easier, to start it from flat body shoes and move on to more complicated footwear types. This is how my students work. They start from flat body shoes, even men that want to create maybe later men's shoes, but they start from flat body shoes and then step by step move to more complicated footwear types. Why you should start to make your shoes from flat body shoes? Because easiest pattern making process. This is not flat body shoes. This is pattern of sneakers. You see how many details it has. It has few details of lining. You see, it consists from three parts of lining, and it has a lot of parts for uppers, and even it has inner parts to reinforce our sneakers in few places. So look at this, all these parts, upper, this is for to design on sneakers, where to sew this element, for example. You see the back part, the upper of the tongue, the upper of the quarters. The for laces, the tongue, it also for laces, and these two parts to reinforce our sneakers. You see, and you need to calculate it to find it correctly on the shoelace to have comfortable sneakers as well. So all these parts you need to find to calculate. Now this is the pattern of flat body shoes, the pattern of upper and pattern of lining. Totally, it consists from three elements, three parts. One part of upper and two part of lining. Now, what do you think for you as a beginner in shoemaking? What be easier to do? Sneakers, boots, or moccasins, or flat body shoes? That's why I always recommend to all beginners in shoemaking to start learning shoemaking, this beautiful craft, from flat ballet shoes. Third reason to start making your shoes from flat ballet shoes is in the process of cutting, assembling, and sewing. You just saw how many details, how many parts has sneakers, and all these details you need to cut, and even more important, all these details you will need to skive. Imagine how it will be complicated for you to skive all these parts then you just started making your shoes. So in flat bodied shoes, you need to skive only this part and this part. That's it. Assembling is the step where you need to assemble all parts of your shoes together. So flat bodied shoes has very simple assembling. You should to assemble lining that consists from two parts, and then lining you need to assemble with upper. That's it. In sneakers, for example, or in boots, or even in moccasins, you have a lot of details to assemble. Lining have few parts. For example, in sneakers you saw it has three parts. All these parts you need to assemble. Then you need to assemble upper and place inside of upper reinforcement. So it's a lot of work, and it could be very complicated for the first time. So that's why I recommend to start from flat body shoes, because it's very easy for each beginners. Sewing is also one thing that you need to have experience, okay? And here you need to sew only one thing, the throat line, okay, and the part of the lining. That's it. Only few seams here you have. And I tell you more, that many of my students, when they started making shoes, they even didn't have sewing machine. That's why they sew by hand. So imagine how it can be easy to sew flat body shoes, because it has only few seams, than to sew sneakers, for example, by hand. It has a lot of difficult work. Okay, so for a first attempt in shoemaking, when you just started making shoes, the flat body shoes is the best way to learn shoemaking step by step, starting from basic footwear types, and then move on when you will have experience to more complicated footwear types. These were three main reasons why you, as a beginner in shoemaking, should start learning shoemaking from flat body shoes. In the next video, I will show you from what you need to start learning shoemaking if you have some problems with your feet, some problematic feet like too big, too narrow, non-standard feet. So if you are ready for the next chapter or have some questions about this tutorial, please comment below. And of course, don't forget to subscribe to the channel and click the bell button to be notified when my new video will come out. Thank you for watching, and see you in the next tutorial. Bye.